Hello guys, good morning and welcome to our channel.
My name is Anagha.
And I'm Abhijit.
And we are travel and food bloggers.
Yes, and today we are in Jaipur. और कल के दिन हम लोग ने दो बार सफर किया, उसमें से एक बार हम लोग को दूर से टाइगर स्पॉट हुआ, that was our luck. But yeah. Today we are going to roam in Jaipur.
And we just have half of the day to spend at Jaipur. Yes. And later on we are going to go to Jaisalmer by train. So that's the plan. So keep watching.
So we just had half a day in Jaipur. So we started off with exploring the main tourist attraction in Jaipur, and that is the Amer Fort. This fort is built over a hill and consists of a huge palace complex. An elephant ride is one of the major tourist attractions at this fort, especially for the foreigners. The fort is majestic and beautiful, and some of the corners of the fort offer a breathtaking view of the city and the places around. As you climb up to the upper courtyard, you will find even more beautiful architectural structures. The fort is divided into a few sections, and each one of them have a separate meaning and significance. This one is the Diwani Arm, also known as the Hall of Public Audience.
Hi guys, so we are going to show you the most gorgeous view from this palace right now.
साइड में आपको चार बिल्डिंग्स पर देखिए पैलेस के अंदर जो पानी का रिक्वायरमेंट होता है ये लोग माउंटेन लेक से ये लोग उससे पानी खींचते थे स्टेप्स के
दिस वन इज द एंट्री टू द दीवानी खास आल्सो नोन एज द हॉल ऑफ प्राइवेट ऑडियंस As soon as you enter into the Diwani Khas, you'll come across a beautiful garden with some fountains in the center and surrounded by beautiful architectural structures on all sides. The beautiful sculpting and painting work done on the walls is simply admirable. Here is the Sheesh Mahal, also known as the Glass Palace, and it's called so because the walls are adorned with beautiful little pieces of mirror glasses which reflect the light in the evening. Since this fort is very huge, it will take at least 2 hours to completely explore and understand this fort. There are many tourist guides available at this fort, and they might charge you around Rs. 300 to Rs. 400, or you can also opt for an audio guide. As you descend towards the exit area, you will come across some artifacts that are preserved in museums.
Hi guys, so right now we are leaving the Amer Fort and maybe we will go at some other place. Let's see. There are no fixed plans. We just have time till 4 o'clock, and after that we have to get ready.
When you are exploring any forts or palace in Rajasthan, do not forget to stop by these local artists that play beautiful, soulful folk music, and they are so good at it.
Thank you.
left the Amer Fort, where we spent quite a lot of time. We were left with only a few hours. We had no fixed plans as such, so we were figuring out where to go next.
So when I zoomed up, I found out that those birds were pelicans. Pelicans have a very unique and huge beak where they can store water and fishes.
This one is the Jal Mahal. We skipped visiting the Jal Mahal and instead decided to go to Jantar Mantar. Jantar Mantar basically consists of 19 archaeological and astronomical instruments like sundials. And this was built by a Rajput king named Sawai Jai Singh II. You will be very intrigued by this place if you are a lover of astronomy. After exploring this place, we got into an auto rickshaw and moved towards Hawa Mahal, which was our last point of attraction. Since we had very less time left with us, it wasn't a detailed visit.
So I just wanted to see the back part of Hawa Mahal, so we skipped going inside and we came on the main road instead.
The back portion of Hawa Mahal is very picturesque. So we just spent a few minutes over here clicking some pictures of this beautiful place. Jaipur was not a part of our travel plans, but since the train that goes to Jaisalmer was from Jaipur, we thought why not explore this beautiful place as much as possible in the meager amount of time that we had. In spite of being low on time, we still ended up doing a bit of shopping before rushing towards some restaurant for lunch. So that was all about our half day trip to Jaipur. If you loved this video, then do give it a thumbs up and also subscribe to our channel if you haven't already, and do press the bell notification. Stay tuned for more and more travel and food vlogs, and we will see you in the next video. Goodbye.